leveled against him by certain members of the Uttarakhand Cricket Association, saying that he tried to communalize the dressing room. Resigning from his post, Jaffer has accused the Uttarakhand Cricket Association of promoting undeserving players. Soon after resigning, the state unit secretary Mahim Verma said Jaffer had communalized the dressing room. He favored Muslim players over the others as while he was coach. Responding to these allegations, Jaffer has said he is really sad that he has to now give an explanation and defend himself in the name of in the face of these allegations. The highest Ranji Trophy run scorer also added that this is the lowest that one can stoop. Jaffer, who has close to 19,000 first-class runs, has been accused of bringing a Maulvi to the cricket ground. Most cricketers have chosen to stay silent on this controversy, barring a few exceptions such as Anil Kumble, who has come out in strong support of the former Indian cricketer. The question really is, aren't these allegations of communal bias being levelled against a man who's given 15 to 20 of years of his life to Indian cricket not just absolutely ridiculous but downright unfair and unjust? In fact, Wasim Jaffer has clearly said that if I was indeed communal in my approach, then I should have been sacked. Why did the Cricket Association of Uttarakhand wait for me to resign before coming out with these bizarre and baseless allegations against me? And of course, as we mentioned, what's equally sad apart from these allegations is that most cricketers past and present, who otherwise are often vocal about several issues, including the farmers' protest, for example, on which we saw the likes of Sachin Tendulkar and Virat Kohli tweet in favor of the Indian government using hashtags put out by the Indian government. But on this issue, when one of their own is under attack, it seems like they're all choosing at the moment to remain silent.